What is going on, everybody? It is Treeb from Treeb Talks here, and you already know what day it is, ladies and gentlemen. It is Wednesday, my dude, so it is time for another Jacksonville Jaguar mock draft. And before we dive into that, got some little bit of news pieces to take care of for you guys. Today, the Jaguars schedule actually drops at 5 p.m. I will be dropping a video on me going over that schedule at around 7 p.m. So this is going to be a two for today. I'm going to have two videos coming out. And some other big news, ladies and gentlemen, is I am trying to get my YouTube Live back up and running. The rumor is that, I mean, not the rumor, but what it is you can go live on your laptop, but for some reason, Treeb can't. I get error messages when I go live, so I'm going to be calling YouTube and I'm going to try and figure that out. But we will be going live for the NFL draft, and me, Bryce, and my friend Barnage, we are both, all three, going to be filling out full first round mock drafts, and there's going to be a competition to see who gets the most picks right and who gets the most wrong. There will be a punishment, so if you have any idea for any punishments for our mock draft challenge, leave them in the comment section down below as well. And finally, the biggest piece of news that I am excited for: if you are a Treeb Talks fan and you want some merchandise, ladies and gentlemen, they are now officially on sale over on my Teespring page. I will leave a link to that in the description down below, as well as pinned in the comment section, if you guys want to get yourself some Treeb Talks merch, ladies and gentlemen. But for the whole reason you're here, ladies and gentlemen, let us dive into the final seven-round mock draft for the Jacksonville Jaguars. Hit that intro.
One to go up top, drops it off across the middle for that.
What is going on, everybody? What is going on, everybody? What is going on, everybody? It is Treeb from Treeb Talks here for another episode of Treeb Talks. Round one, tight end, TJ Hawkinson. Now, it's my final mock draft, ladies and gentlemen, so I'm going all out. I'm giving you what I think the Jaguars are going to do. I didn't even do this on FanSpeak. I combined a lot, all five of my mock drafts that I've done so far, to formulate the mock draft that I think is most likely going to happen with the Jaguars, and one that I personally want as well. And what I want at seven, or even if we trade back, is tight end TJ Hawkinson. I don't want Jawan Taylor. If you did not see my six pitches for the Jaguars' first round pick, please go do so. I explain why I don't want Jawan Taylor and why I think it's just a little bit too obvious for the Jags, and why I just don't think that's what the pick's going to be. But TJ Hawkinson, who is going to help Nick Foles out tremendously and help out the tight end depth as a whole tremendously, and he's the best tight end in this draft by far. Noah Fant, he's right there, and they were teammates, so they're both very talented tight ends, very two talented cats, and I think TJ Hawkinson should be the first round selection for the Jags, and I hope that it's a first round selection for the Jags, and he comes in as my first round pick for my last and final mock draft. Round two, wide receiver, A.J. Brown. Every day this pick is getting less and less likely, but I'm telling you, I'm doing this based off of what I really want to happen. And if A.J. Brown slips to the second round, the Jags better be all on that business. A.J. Brown is the best wide receiver in this year's draft. I have talked about him time and time again in these videos, talking about how talented he is, saying that he was really the star at Ole Miss, but DK Metcalf's size and his combine really outshined A.J. Brown. But he is, without a doubt, the best wide receiver in this draft, from speed to route running to hands. He is an all-around great wide receiver and somebody that the Jags should be itching to get on their squad. And hopefully he is there in the second round. But if not, I'd still like to see the Jaguars try and target a wide receiver in the second round, especially if we go, you know, either offensive tackle or tight end in the first round. I would like to see us attack the wide receiver position in the second round with the best receiver available, even if that's not A.J. Brown. This is a pretty solid wide receiver class. You know, a lot of people seem to not agree with that, but some people do. I like a lot of receivers in this draft: Akeem Butler, N'Keal Henry, AJ Brown. I like DK Metcalf. I think he has potential, and I'm excited to see where he goes and how well he plays. But I don't think he's the best receiver in this draft class. I think AJ Brown is. So any receiver really in the second round, I'd be okay with. I'm just really, really hoping it's AJ Brown, because the kid has a lot of talent and he's rising up draft boards, and, you know, rightfully so, because this guy is very, very talented, and I really, really hope to see him in Jaguar black and teal. Round 3, Deontay Thompson, safety. Now, a lot of people get angry with me when I don't address the safety position because they don't trust Jared Wilson like I trust Jared Wilson. And I understand that, and I think he does need to have somebody come in and give him a run for his money, and that's what Deontay Thompson is going to do. He's an Alabama safety, so that'd be cool if we had him and Ronnie Harrison holding it down in the back, you know, former teammates. Those two were really, really good in at Alabama, so these two could be a really good tandem. And again, he can give Jared Wilson a run for his money, and he's going to be there in the third round. And he's one of the more underrated safeties in this year's draft. You know, the safety position's not really talked about as much as other positions, but there's some solid safeties there, and you know, a lot of teams are going to be kind of waiting on it. So Deontay Thompson should be there in the third round and should be there to help solidify the depth at the safety position for the Jacksonville Jaguars. And you guys don't have to get angry with me in the comments section for not picking a safety to compete with Jared Wilson. And I finally did it with my last installment of my mock draft. So Deontay Thompson is going to be competing with Jared Wilson, and hopefully we can see him and Ronnie Harrison on the field together, those two Alabama boys. Round 3, pick 34, edge rusher Christian Miller, Texas A&M. The Jaguars are going to have to address the edge and the interior defensive line position, or one or the other, and so we have a reliable rotation. I decided to go with the edge rusher with Christian Miller, who's one of the honestly better edge rushers in this year's draft class that is going to be available later on. I think he has tremendous upside. His floor is even a little high, so you know, he's had good years at Texas A&M, and he's been a solid piece to that defense you know, since he's been starting for the team. And you know, he's a tremendous player, and he has opportunity to come in for guys like Yannick Ngakoue or Calais Campbell when they need a rest. And I'm excited to see what this kid can do, and I think that he would look good in Jaguar black and teal, obviously. And I think that he would help at the depth at those positions, so we can be, you know, as healthy and as reliable and as, you know, consistent as we possibly can be on the defensive side of the ball. So he could come in for Yannick Ngakoue on first and second down, maybe, you know, and then Yan come in on third down, obviously the better pass rusher. So, you know, Christian Miller, he's going to fill in that hole of a rotational defensive end, kind of playing the Dante Fowler role, and I think he's going to play that really well. And I think that getting him in the third round would be a huge steal, and getting him and Deontay Thompson in this third round, I think, would make a lot of Jags fans happy. Round 4, pick 7, Will Grier, quarterback. Now, I didn't have Will Grier on any of my other previous mock drafts. I've waited until the 7th round to do so, but in this mock draft, I have two guys in the 6th and 7th round that I really, really enjoy, and I think are two really, really big sleepers. So I decided not to get a quarterback in those later rounds. I decided to address it a little earlier. And Will Grier is a guy that keeps falling and falling on people's draft boards. And he was a guy that was allegedly supposed to be the best quarterback in this year's draft. You know, towards the beginning of the regular season, people were all about Will Grier and all about his mechanics, his arm, everything. But, you know, the combine happened, his pro day, and, you know, guys like Dwayne Haskins and Kyler Murray kind of took over for him and, you know, are being more looked at prospects. Even Danielle Jones took over him and Drew Locke. And Will Grier's not even in the top 5 quarterbacks of this class, which was, you know, that's nutty to think, you know, from a couple, 5-6 months ago, Will Grier was the guy that everybody was talking about. They were talking about Will Grier over, like, Dwayne Haskins and Kyler Murray. And I think this guy does have some upside and some potential, and it's a good thing we're not going to be drafting him to start for us, because then we'd be in a real predicament there. But he's going to be learning behind Nick Foles, learning the system, developing the guy, and making sure he has all the intangibles to be a good quarterback in the NFL, and maybe step in for Nick Foles once he calls it you know, here in Jacksonville, and maybe Will Greer will be our next quarterback. And hopefully by then he's going to, you know, been shown the ropes and really understand the position of the quarterback in the NFL. So Will Greer is going to be our fourth round selection. So we address the backup quarterback role, and, you know, it's not going to be Cody Kessler. So thank God we don't got to go through that travesty again in 2019. Round six, running back, Miles Gaskin, Washington. I will not let this go. Simple as that. Will not let this go. I don't care how many running backs the Jaguars selected. I want Miles Gaskin. And I want him late. Because I want him to just shine on all of y'all. And then he's going to be big flexing in the back saying, Treeb was right. I'm the future. I'm the running back. And he's going to take over for Leonard Fournette. He's going to break, you know, the all-time Jaguar rushing record. Okay, maybe I'm getting a little bit too ahead of myself. But Miles Gaskin's a guy that I've been talking about in all of my mock drafts for the past 5 weeks, ladies and gentlemen. So if you don't know how I feel about him, if that whole, you know, rant there didn't tell you how well I feel about him, how good I feel about him as a player, you know, watch any of my other mock drafts where I go a little bit more in depth on Miles Gaskin, the player. 4 straight years of 1,000 or more yards at the University of Washington. The offense was ran through Miles Gaskin in Washington, and that's a guy Jacksonville needs. They need a running back who's used to having the whole entire offense run through you, because that is what the Jaguar offense is. It's just running right through Leonard Fournette. And, you know, Miles Gaskin has been in that role before. He knows how to play it, and he could be a really, really solid addition to this running back room and could be some competition, breathing down guys like Thomas Rawls, Alfred Blue, Benny Cunningham, breathing down their necks. So, you know they have to work hard in training camp, because this Miles Gaskin guy is knocking on the door of a roster spot, and he might just get it over you. Round 7, linebacker Caden Ellis, Idaho. I want the Jags to draft Caden Ellis because he's going to be the biggest sleeper in this year's draft. You haven't heard of him. He goes to the University of Idaho, which is a Big Sky school. It's not necessarily the biggest school. It's still a Division I school. It's just in the FCS instead of the FBS. So, you know, that's how it's been for him. And he has been a standout player all 4 years at the University of Idaho. I work for a newspaper here in Lewiston, Idaho, and that's the main football team we cover here, which is the University of Idaho. I've seen Caden Ellis develop from a freshman to a senior to now one of the most slept-on NFL draft prospects in 2019. I'm really excited for him, and I'm really excited to see where he lands, because he's going to be a terrific player no matter where he lands. This is going to be a little bit of a personal bias here, picking him in round 7 for the Jags, but we do need some help at some linebacker depth. We do have some linebackers that are there for linebacker depth, but they're more of special teamers. We need a guy that could come on the field and really, you know, direct traffic and be that guy. And that is what Caden Ellis is. And I think that he's going to be kind of like Leon Jacobs, you know, a 7th round linebacking choice that's going to get some playing time and be able to shine a little bit and have the, you know, opportunity to play a little bit. And he also, I guarantee, could dominate on special teams. The kid has a high, high motor. He's strong as well. And this guy could do a lot for Jacksonville, whether that is playing the linebacking spot or just contributing on special teams. Caden Ellis is going to be one hell of a signing for the Jacksonville Jaguars. And that was my final 7-round mock draft for the Jacksonville Jaguars. What'd you guys think? Leave your comments down below. Don't forget, check the links down below as well. You can like me on Facebook at Treeb Talks. Follow me on Twitter at Treeb Talks. Follow me on Instagram at Trey Vaughn Pixley. You can also check out my Teespring page. Get you some Treeb Talks merchandise. Rock with Treeb no matter where you go, ladies and gentlemen. Also, if you haven't yet, hit that subscribe button. Click the bell icon so you get notified every single time I drop a new video. I drop new content on this channel 6 days a week. Ain't nobody outworking me. Them's just straight facts. Thank you guys so much for watching this video. And as always, you guys have a great day.